Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Hope my voice is reaching you. See, I got robbed in Bangkok, Thailand. How I'll tell you. Actually, my purse was made of this material. See, it's like this thing. It was a bit like this. So you might say it's sort of parachute or something. So this purse was a bit bigger in size and I had it here. See, when I was shopping, it was like this. So it went to on my back and somebody cut it with a blade. Imagine it's a purse. Now what happens is when we go for shopping, we have it like this and see the bag money is. So when we go to a shop for shopping or when we're buying anything, we are looking there. See, we are looking there and our money is here. See, at the bag, this is the money. Now we are looking there and the pickpocket knows that your concentration is there at the shop because they are there to rob you. He cut through my purse because I was like, you know, my purse was like this. So this was where the money was, this side, behind my, you know, at my back. And he cut it through, cut it open, and he took out my money. And I'll tell you the rest of the story. So you should always have your bag. If you have it like this, keep the money side in front of you here. Look at the clothes or buy anything. So you always have it here. So nobody can cut it through, right? Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. See, when I got robbed in Bangkok, I did not have a clue because as a Muslim, whenever I go out of my house or hotel, I always recite Allah's name. It was early morning time and it was Racha Prarop area in Bangkok, and there was a market which has really close stalls next to each other, and inside the market, in one of the stalls, I was looking at the clothes and somebody, you know, cut open my purse with a blade and I could not know. So when I finally saw, then after I saw, then a Thai lady came to me and she said, your purse is open, cut open. So Just before that, I had seen by myself that it has happened, and I had lost my a lot of my currency and original NIC, like identity card of Pakistan. Because of the NIC, I went to a Thai lady. I guess she was a Thai. She looked like a local Thai. I asked her at the same market, you know, that this has happened. She said, I've heard similar cases before also. So I said to her that, you know, I want to go to the concerned police station. She said, I know the, you know, she started telling me the address, and I think she said or I said to her that please write it down in Thai language. So she wrote it down. I went to the police station and completely reversed to the mostly the reputation that police has in my country. It was very, very opposite there. They were very nice to me at the station. I did not feel as a lady, and the camera is shaking because of my cat. So it's not an earthquake, Allah ka shukr. So person at the police station, he heard me. Most of all, he could understand English. A few things I had to tell him, you know, that I'm saying this. This whole thing happened a few years back in Bangkok. And he listened to me, then he asked me to tell the whole story and my details to the person also sitting at the in another room, and he also himself wrote down a few things. Then they gave me a copy of the FIR because it was very very important for me to, you know, lodge an FIR, because if the lady or guy who had robbed me could have been involved in something else also. They were already involved in robbery and pickpocketing, but if, you know, my document was to be found anywhere with them, they could have thought that, you know, I was involved with them in all this. So I made sure, I told them that could you please, you know, use the security cameras there, or, you know, do something about it. So anyways, I was very pleased to find, I was very pleased to find out that they were very nice to me. In my country, I'm very scared of the police, and here it was the opposite. I was very calm, very comfortably. I was talking to him. They were dealing with me very nicely, they did not use any rude language or rude behavior. They were instead very nice to me, very nicely they heard me and everything. So it was something unpredictable. Obviously, I know that, you know, we should always recite Allah's name. And if you think my video was useful to you, so please remember me in your prayers, and my cat also. Thank you. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.